All right. Cool. So I am here currently with the rank one of our NA Wild Hearthstone, Thomas Carter, who came up with the perfect 40-card list of Huhuran Hunter. Tom, this is if I get this right, this was the sixth version of this deck that you went through.
So on my deck tracker, it says 4.3, I think. Yeah, it says 4.3, but the deck tracker broke midway, so I'm pretty sure that it must be the sixth version. I went back and forth with a couple of cards as well, so yeah.
Okay.
I played a lot of games.
How many do you have? Do you have an idea of how many games it is off the top of your head with this version?
Yes. With the current version or the full climb?
Let's just say current version.
Yes, the last version, I think it's 20 games, actually.
Okay.
It's really small.
Okay, the latest version is just 20 games. All right, so I think the first... I think there's going to be a lot of videos on this. I think you're going to have just the main content creators do it. You know, I don't even know if Martian's done one yet, but I'm assuming like Martian, Raffle, Dane...
Oh, Raffle... Yeah, Ruffle already made a video, and I found a little comment that said, oh, actually, the deck, someone has a version. Tom, he's ranked one. I was like, damn, I think that I didn't make my tweet yet. Like, they know my name. Wow.
Well, I know Sadisi hit something similar. So, like, I think he hit rank one and then sat on it, if I recall.
Yeah, but it said Tom, not Sadisi.
Oh, was that who it was? Okay, I thought it was Sadisi for some reason.
No. It named me particularly Tom.
Oh right. Oh, he said you. Oh, you hit. He said you hit rank one with it, but you hadn't hit it yet. Got you. Okay. Oh,
no. I had hit it, but I didn't make the tweet. I think.
Oh, got you. Okay, I get
it now.
They
had the letter, or they had the inside info.
How did he know? How did he know?
Right.
So
and I had to switch to my other YouTube account, which is Tom Carter. And I made a comment, like, because they said, oh, Tom plays on Asia. And I was like, no, I play on
NA.
And they were, like, all sweaty, like, oh, hi, Tom. on the comment.
That's cute.
That was really funny.
You got him a bunch of engagement just from people being like, hi, Tom. So I think I want to, I think a bunch of people are already going to be making, like, a video basically reacting and, like, gameplay of the list and whatever. So what I think I want to do is, like, something a little bit different. I want to talk about the deck building behind it, because this thing was a god-awful mess coming together, I think is, and that's, like, kind of an understatement. Just, like, watching how many permutations and how many things people tried and how many bad lists are out there. So let's just start with some of your brave choices, and I think your list is the best list, and like you have been the lodestone, the guiding star, the player that I've basically been following the closest making this list, because I think I have really synced up and enjoyed your choices. So let's start with, like, I think the first big one you made. Can you talk about why you went XL with it?
So the reason I went XL was mainly two reasons. Originally, when the deck was 30, it ran Mad Scientist, I think it's the name of the secret minion,
yep.
The 2-2.
Yep.
And Explosive Trap. And I was like, no, I need something else to help me deal with aggro. Aggro is really an issue here. And I was like, you know what? 10 HP sounds really good against aggro.
Yeah, sure.
And the deck also has a couple patches in it. But the thing is that it doesn't work like Big Priest. Big Priest would love to have Renafall in it, maybe.
Right.
No one plays Big Priest.
Right.
But the problem is it's a minion. But here we have specific tutors for everything that we want to have. So I said, Renafall is not a beast. You go in.
Right.
And in it went. Yeah.
So just real quick, just to clarify, just for people watching who aren't sure what you mean by patches, like, we have the Mokhnathal Lions and we have the princess herself. You never want to draw those. Like drawing those is bad. We even run, Sir Finley Sea Guide in part to shuffle them back in, part to dig for a better hand. But part of his function is like, oh, hell yeah, we can send this back into the deck. You don't want to draw those minions because you want to keep popping them off of egg. And so.
Yes, and I even managed to take a couple Shadow Shamans to fatigue, almost.
Oh, wow,
Like
really?
three cards left on the deck. Yeah, because they are Exile and I'm also Exile. And I can shuffle my patches
Right.
back into
Oh,
deck.
yeah.
And
You could
they
do like
couldn't
the
deal with
little,
that.
yeah, you could do like the little
Yeah.
fatigue shuffle where you just you send a bunch of stuff back in, and then it's like, oh, look, I got another 10, 20, I got another 8, 9, 10 cards for fatigue. Sweet. So that was a brave, I think that was a brave inclusion. I think you were the first person I saw to go XL with it. And again, the idea of like, it's pretty easy to tutor for the pieces that we want, but having the extra HP and not drawing the cards that we don't want to draw, reducing that chance made a lot of sense to me. And so I wanted to point that out as like pretty cool deck building where like, hey, here's a case where like we are actually leveraging the positives of the additional cards in the list, which I thought was cool. Can we talk about the meat wagon?
We sure can. First, I would like to answer Flair because I saw a question here on the chat. Did you try Sphere? No, because Sphere is bad. You don't want to shuffle things back in your deck. You run tradables. It's a slow card. I do nothing with it, and I have two other weapons which are much better, and we can talk about those later. Sphere
Sure.
is bad. It's not a meme deck. It is actually a good deck now.
Yeah, I've seen some versions that do run Sphere, but like from and again, we'll talk about the True Aim Crescents. I feel like True Aim Crescent is so good. Like you half the time you're getting maybe one filtered draw, and I feel like when you're running Sphere, you're almost accepting whatever the top deck is a lot of the times because like otherwise if you don't, you're running the risk of allowing one of your things you're supposed to filter from slipping through. So it put it, it's just it's awkward and weird and bad, kind of like you were saying.
Yeah, and also again, the idea here is that one of the first changes, as you well mentioned, is making it Excel, and Sphere doesn't have any attack. It has a zero weapon, a zero attack weapon.
Yeah.
So I do nothing against aggro. I just play a Sphere and I perish, which I don't like.
We don't like perishing, no. All right, late. Can people beat the meat wagon? Can we beat the meat? What's going on with the meat wagon?
The meat wagon. So the meat wagon actually, I don't know where it came from. I think, and this is going to sound bad for some, but I think that I saw it featured on a list that Mark MCKC was running.
Okay.
And I was like, I cannot believe that. Is there something behind that? Let me give it a try. Give me 1 second. Because the issue again was when I made it 40, I was like, okay, now I have a bunch of spaces that I need to fill in. And I want to tutor my cards.
Yeah, for sure.
But I don't want blind draw. The problem with the deck is that if you have blind draw, you draw the things you don't want to draw. And Meat Wagon is such a niche card. It has such a specific synergy in this deck altogether with so many cards. It just makes
Yeah, that's
sense.
true. It's true. And like again, its main function being to pull out the zero attack mystery egg. We've done this before with like something like Frog Shaman, right? Like I know Labore famously with his like giants like Overload Shaman
Right, but the
was
thing
doing
is
stuff
that.
like that. Yeah.
Right, but the thing is that Shaman didn't have a really good way to destroy their own meat wagon. And the problem is that once you destroy your meat wagon, you probably use the spell and you wanted to have the spell for the frog.
Right.
The quote unquote problem here is that meat wagon gets discounted by another hunter card not accessible to Shaman, which is and remember the name, the one mana spell
Carrion Studies.
there, Carrion Studies. There we go. And you can also discover it for me, which I've done plenty of times, which is super tilting for my
Yeah,
opponent,
it's
but that's.
goofy. I did that the other I did the other day. I was like, oh, there's a meat wagon, cool.
And you can kill your meat wagon with Devouring Swarm, Playdead, the Triumph Crescent, which again is one of the reasons it's there. You trade and you do the goofy thing. And not only gets discounted by Korean studies, it also gets discounted by Timelag Accelerator,
Right.
which is a new car. It was not there back when we did the thing with Shaman.
True.
So suddenly you can have on turn four, instead of just dropping a mid wagon, you have a one mana mid wagon, and you have play dead, and you go from there.
That's pretty sick. That's pretty
And if
sick.
you draw, even if you drop it on four, you sometimes have the Huhuran in hand, which is not ideal, but you can use the Huhuran
On
on the
curve.
mid wagon.
Oh, cool. Yeah.
Yeah, and suddenly you have an egg, and they if they kill the egg, they give you a free thing. If they kill the mid wagon and you have the other egg on the deck, now you have another egg, and they are going to give you another free thing. And it just snowballs from there. And another card that is good, and the reason we have mid wagon, is 9 lives. If they kill the mid wagon, they deal with the egg, and let's say that they deal with a follow up of a free thing. You just play 9 lives for the mid wagon, and you pull the second egg. And you have your spells, you have your free things that you got from the egg that they killed, and you go from there.
And you
So
start popping
you
off.
had no board. They managed to deal with the whole thing. And the funny thing is that 9 lives does not care if the minion was silenced, as long as it dies.
Right. So
So,
that can save you too, as far as like, oh, my meat wagon got silenced. As long as you get it dead, you can
right.
still go find the thing. That's cool.
Exactly. So it happened plenty of times where the mid wagon just gets silenced. Doesn't matter because you have 9 lives and it says the rattle death rattle minion that died. Condition unspecified. And you go from there.
Cool.
Another card, which was actually the latest iteration, the latest version, is Doggy Biscuit, which I also want to
Dude, I was
mention
gonna
here
bring up
since
the
we're talking
doggy biscuit.
about
The
the.
doggy
Yeah.
biscuit is so inspired, actually. Having like I hadn't played it your version with doggy biscuit yet, and then I started playing. I was like, oh wait, this makes a lot of sense.
I was on it. I was thinking about it. That was my actually 39-40 card for at least the last 50 games, I want to say. And I was really, really on the fence on it. And a really good player said, what if it's actually Doggy Biscuit? And they haven't played the deck. I don't think they are playing much wild at all. And I was like, you know what? I trust your decision because you are a better player than I. And I just switch a card for that. And it turns out that giving rush to, even if you board lock yourself, which can sometimes happen when you have all Huhurans and no lions,
Right.
you trade, and suddenly your Huhuran can trade.
Yeah.
And you may even get a free board space and just whoop, go from there again. And gives rush to the mid wagon. So yeah, sometimes you
Rush
can
the meat
actually
wagon,
keep
buff an egg, like
Doki
buff an
Biscuit.
egg so you can trade with the egg, which is sometimes relevant. Like it's really neat.
It never happened to me, but I guess you could.
I've done it. I've done it. Maybe I shouldn't have done it, but I've done it.
I don't know, but yeah, no, it was the latest card, and I was like, "Yep, that goes in. Yep, most
It
definitely."
went down like again. It can be like cheap damage if you really need it to be. You don't always need it to be, but it can be. I think there's definitely two more things we got to ask you about. Well, three things because we got to talk about the weapons too. But like, I think one of the big debates that raged all the time was main deck Rhino versus Rhino in the ETC. I am fervently on Rhino in the ET team, Rhino on the ETC team. I hate bricking the combo and not getting either Princess or the Lion, but take me through what the thought process here as far as putting this in and why you settled on this, because I know you were kind of on the fence, or even like situationally, you could see it going either way.
Yes. So the main thing that made me switch the Rhino to the ETC was that on the final version that I made, which is what you currently have, I managed to gather enough chip damage. Not chip as in inexpensive chip.
Yeah, chip. Yep, yep, yep.
Small, yeah, pew pew.
Pew pew.
The problem was that before that, the other iterations of the list didn't have much of that. So against Reno decks, which could deal with board after board after board, you kind of needed the Reno, so you could go face with a couple Huhurans, a couple Lions right. in a while, so you could chip with that.
Right.
The problem was, again, breaking. So Rhino, not main deck, is better against Reno, which I've seen people talk about as well. A player that I faced many times was Triple Lift, who was playing Reno Warrior. And he much rather faced the version that has ETC with a Rhino in it, because he knows he loses if Rhino is not in the ETC because of the chip damage.
Right, right, right.
So Rhino, Tundra is better main deck against Rhino, worse against aggro. Against aggro, against giants, you want the lion, and you want the Huhuran.
And I think that's probably where my experience is, definitely on my stream, and again, where I typically am playing. I'm seeing more aggro. I'm still seeing Miracle Rogue. And so I want the consistency of, I really need the lions. I need the lions for the trades. And so getting a Tundra Rhino, sometimes it solves the board, and sometimes it's the first card you get and you absolutely break and you've died. And so and that was like, that immediately turned me off to the experience. But again, I think there's also some clever ways where, knowing Rhino is in tech, you can kind of do a little finagling with your play patterns where you can make sure you get more than one trigger, I guess, is the way that you kind of play around that aspect, because it is more likely to get Lions and Princess than Rhino. It just still felt bad to me. It still felt bad.
Right, but again, the thing that made me switch for about, I believe, 20 games as well, was that I was in a pocket meta that was LPG mage or some hero power mage with
right.
Reno things.
Yeah, yeah.
Reno warrior, Shadow Shaman. I had to make the switch for about 20 games because
you're in that greed pocket. It made sense for that greed pocket.
Right.
Yeah, it makes sense.
But against I totally understand being behind the Rhino on the ETC, which is currently the version that you have featured there, because now we have sort of ways of pushing more damage, and you don't actually need it. But in that super greedy pocket meta that I had to face, I decided
you
to
made the decision
main deck
to do
it for a couple of games.
Yeah, makes sense. Yeah. Makes sense. I mean, there was even one great game where it's just like, I had the Rhino in hand, and it felt like the opposite of patches. I was like, ooh, this is good. And so I have it, and I can drop it whenever I want. And I don't have to tip my hand that I've got the ETC. Though I will say, the amount of times we're doing turns where we're playing like princesses for free and lions for free, like, you don't float mana because you find things to do with it, but like, you could easily take a turn and float 4, 5, 6 mana because you just could. Like, I mean, like, obviously we have a hero power. We already spend it on the hero power. We always find ways to do something with the mana, but once this deck starts rolling, the actual combo itself doesn't require any mana, which is part of why it's so stupid broken, right? It feels like we're playing duels almost. So ETC to go fetch Rhino doesn't feel like a tempo loss because you're still trading for free with Lion, or you're still making 5-6s with 6-5s with Princess. So, like, I don't know. I don't hate the ETC. I don't hate it there. Let's talk about another brave choice that you make, that you stand by, that you swear by. Let's talk about the double dirty rats.
Oh, that is amazing. Okay, so after making it Renathal, adding Bola Shot, which I saw in some versions, Bite was in the original version. I don't think I had the weapon, but we already had the idea that we needed something to deal with aggro, and we were good with the aggro things. We ran into another problem, which is, how do you deal with combo? And I've discovered Plague Spreader many times from Karen studies and dealing with many players, but sometimes you don't. And you need to be able to screw with
Yeah,
with the
you
combo.
gotta at least try a
Yeah.
little bit.
And another fascinating thing is that this deck always wants to trade. You always not only you want to have presence on board, you want to eliminate by trading, and the way that you manage to build a board is to take away their tempo. But you need to trade. What
Right.
happens when they don't play minions?
Right.
You force them to.
Here's a backboard. I need a backboard. It's an alley-oop. The dirty rat's an alley-oop. I love that I love that that use of the card, aside from just, pure disruption, just like, hey, I need to hit into something. Oh, here's the thing to hit into. Did Knuckles
Yeah,
Hunter
no,
ever do that? I can't remember. We would talk about I would watch people who played Knuckles Hunter like look at things like Magtherodon and crazy stuff like that for options. Dirty Rat is just so much cheaper and I think more effective.
no, and the reason they don't run DD Rat is because, as you previously mentioned, this deck plays their minions for free. Knuckles Hunter does not.
Right.
So here, I suddenly see myself, and Knuckles Hunter didn't really want it to trade to generate value. I wanted to trade to kill, which
Right.
is different.
Right.
And here, once we have set up our combo, we are just doing things for 0 mana. And instead of floating mana, as you said, you float 4 mana. Let's use 2 for hero power. Oh, would you look at that? The Tyrat is a 2 mana minion.
Yeah.
And you're suddenly, whoops, I drop this, and you suddenly take a Rhino, take a Ziliax, you take a boat. The fact that you can play Rat when you're ahead against aggro or
Yeah.
against Garrote.
And still trade. And like you don't hate pulling a big thing either, because a big thing means you get more procs, honestly, off of Lion. So like it's not even it's like you have infinite removal. It doesn't you don't really care. You just as long as you have the board space, right? So
Oh no, the level of insanity is that you can play this card, you can play this Dirty Rat on 4 against Big Shaman and you don't care about it.
right.
As long as you had the combo. Who would play a Dirty Rat against Big Shaman? Only this deck can handle that, which is kinda dumb.
Yeah, it is kind of dumb. Like I said, it feels very duelsy. Like when we're doing the thing, it feels very much like a duel style board setup where you're generating infinite resources for no mana, and it's just the game sort of devolves into a dumb. All right, I wanted to talk about the rats. All right, so go ahead.
Oh
What were you
yeah.
saying? What were you gonna say?
Oh yeah, and the thing that makes it feel very dulcy, and not just a straight up combo like you would find just randomly generating on ladder. And I was looking at the Tempo Storm, they made an article about the most broken decks of all time. And all of those decks, once they kind of vomited what they wanted to do, you had to deal with that, and if you could, maybe they couldn't get ahead. The issue with this deck is that you do the thing, you float the board, you disrupt their things, and when they kill your stuff, you just get more back.
Yeah.
So you have a full hand, which didn't happen with many other broken decks.
It wasn't like they were out of gas. Like, no, you're still going. In fact,
It's
Reno
very
Lone
hard to
Ranger
run out
might
of
be the
gas.
one like true answer to this deck, right? Like, to a certain extent, just like the erasure of the board state, and then you have to start over again, and you get time walked a turn.
It is more about the time lock than anything else,
Yeah,
truly.
okay. Makes sense. 'Cause again, you usually have stuff built up for free that you're not necessarily
Yeah,
using
no,
right away.
I'm probably going to mill. Like, if you play Reno and I did the thing, and we are on turn 9 and I haven't killed you, I'm probably going to mill. I'm going to play a 0 mana something on board, and I'm going to be very sad because probably 8 of my 10 cards in hand are 0 mana beasts.
All right.
And I'm just not able to drop them because of the battle cry of Reno locking you for 1 minion.
Were you the one who added the True Aim Crescents? Is this your
Yes.
touch? All right, so let's talk about the weapons. Let's talk me through the weapons.
So, the first reason for the weapon, was actually me looking at things that could kill the wagon or could kill the egg if I wanted to. I then realized that that car is kind of broken against any kind of freeze, and it's really good against aggro. It's a one mana 1/4. Like, for example, one of the most iconic hunter cards, which saw play for many years, was Candleshot, and it was a one mana 1/3. So this is kind of powerful. So yeah, I was just looking for things that could give me cheap, could give me something. I wanted a second playdead, and I looked throughout the whole collection. And the main thing with the deck is you don't wanna have too many minions because you run Stitch Tracker. You cannot run any other beasts. You
That
cannot
was part
run
of the
any
refinement.
other mechs.
Yeah, the part of the refinement was like paring down the minions and bringing in more spells to make Stitch Tracker a little bit more consistent than what we were getting. And thinking about it now too, Stitch Tracker is a copy, right? So like this is almost like perfect for what this deck is trying to do sometimes. Like you can go find an egg and you still have two more eggs in deck for the meat wagon, which is kind of cool. But sorry, I interrupted you. What were you saying?
Oh no, and again the thing is that I looked here for cards to add. So I had to do cards I cannot add first, which was any spell that is one mana is out because Trinket Tracker needs to be consistent on exactly those spells. I cannot add any other one mana spell.
Yeah,
Zero
it
mana
makes sense.
spells, I look at them, they kinda suck. Moving on. Look at two mana spells. And we have Varrak on the deck. So that was also the reason I got the secrets. Because I wanted to tutor them. Either I had a version with Bunker or with the Mad Scientist. But drawing a secret out of Varrak is horrible.
Yeah.
Feels really bad. I couldn't add, so my two mana spells had to be fairly consistent. No other three mana spell. Because I want Barak to always hit 9 lives,
Always
nothing
nine lives,
else.
yep.
And again, I cannot add any other mechs, I cannot add any other beasts. So
Right.
I was in a weird spot, which was, do I just run Rexxar at this point?
Right. You're starting to look at sixes. You're like, well, Tavish is good, but do we run Rexxar for heal for five with a shitty hero power? And it's almost, I know you ultimately said no for very good reasons, but also like, it's generating more. There's a good chance that the best beast you can make is diluting the nine lives pool too sometimes.
Yeah, probably. So I started looking at weapons, and suddenly I see this, which works perfectly, which for what I want to do, which is trade. If my thing cannot attack, it's not expensive because I also looked at the other weapon that was worth looking for was the Dredge weapon,
Okay, sure.
but it's kind of bad because you actually don't want your beasts,
Yeah.
so you are never using the discount.
So yeah,
So it was
you're
just
just
that.
harpooning for the sake of harpooning, but you never want to draw the beasts.
Right, it was
Yeah.
basically a worse war fairy axe
Yeah.
for no reason.
So I think the one question I have remaining, because I think you've actually done a pretty good job of comprehensively going through the list and your decisions for it. And when you look at it, like it makes a lot of sense. Again, we do queue things with it. It's worth mentioning. Flair mentioned in chat, right? The Bolas shots, the Grievous Bites. We can do cute things, popping our own stuff. Grievous Bite getting debuffed to three damage to a minion is actually super relevant for this deck specifically, right? In case we gotta pop our own egg for whatever reason. Ideally, that.
Oh, and it deals with any boat, any cannon,
Void touch attendants.
attendant. Yeah, it's excellent. And the thing is that what happens most of the time, the boat is next to Apaches
Or
or
just
something
something with
with
one
one
health,
HP.
right?
So yeah, it is You know, against aggro.
Cool.
Tough case.
So I think the one thing that I think I still have an outstanding question about is two timeline accelerators. Because I know when I'm trying to list, I feel so low when the timeline accelerator draws the timeline accelerator. Or are you just kind of fine with that? And like trying to find a 30th card, 40th card at this point is like.
trying to find a 40 card was basically useless. I actually think that I played one game, or I actually canceled my cube midway. And I was like, you know what? Because I was running one copy of the Dredge weapon and only one accelerator.
Right.
And it made no sense, basically.
Right.
Because at this point, adding any other minion is going to dilute the tracker.
Yep.
Yeah,
it can't even be a different minion because it's just that's a different option off a stitch tracker. That's a good point.
Right. Again, I cannot add any other one mana spells, nope. Three mana spells. The only other card that I was kind of looking at was Dire Frenzy.
Okay.
But it's basically impossible to play.
Yeah. I was noticing that. You had that in your ETC for a hot minute. The Dire Frenzy. And it's just like, oh, to shuffle stuff back. But like, it was super situational, right? Like, okay, great. We have more copies of our beast in our deck. But the odds of you being able to actually play it seemed kind of slim.
Right, not even. And the only other card that you could consider here is Stronghold Heart, I think it's called, the 8 mana 3 level spell.
Which one? Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I don't remember the name. It plays the little ta-da-da-da music. The legendary spell, right?
Yeah. We call it life, sure, yeah. We call it life.
Life, okay.
We call it life. It's not, but it looks like the life emote, so...
Sure. So the thing that, I really find it funny when I showed the, when I posted the deck and I tagged Neon is Hearthstone decks, by the way, for those that don't know, sometimes he features the rank and how many games were played. For my submission, he did not put how many games I played.
Right.
And it was there on the tweet. So the thing that people need to understand is that I play a lot of Hearthstone. And when I say that, it's not, oh, he plays a lot of Hearthstone. No, I play a lot of Hearthstone. This was my climb from Bronze 10 to rank 1, and it took 260 games in 4.5 days. That was about 7 hours of Hearthstone a day.
Yeah, you were big right. It's four and a half days. It's the fifth of the month, so you've been going. You've been basically. This month has been. This has been it. You're at the top of the chain. You're at the top of the heap. Five days into the month, have you been had to defend yet or not really?
I was thinking about playing tonight. I haven't had to defend it yet, but I'm looking at the. So what you need to do is look at rank 5 and lower and see if there are many changes there. And there have been a couple of changes. So I think that I'm going to just jam a bunch of games on rank 1 and set it so high that taking it away from me is going to take winning 11 games in a row.
What are you
going
to do? What are you going to do other than play Wild Hearthstone? Literally anything
else?
No,
play Standard.
Play Standard?
Yeah, get my rank back in Standard, yeah.
Awesome.
I got 11x on both formats last month. The only other spell you can consider is the heart. And the reason that I'm mentioning how many games I played is that from the get-go, life was in my deck.
Right.
I have never played it in 260 games.
Never.
So I was like, you know what? Out. I added the other tradables and I was like, yep. Better tradables, cheaper, and they do more things.
So much better. Ow. Yeah, the doggy biscuit feels like it has so much more utility than just like, okay, we have this gigantic bomb of stuff that like it might have charge, it might not have charge, it just might be a bunch of 5/2s. Like it's with no death rattle, so it's not like they reproduce themselves. Yeah, I could 100% see that. I could see
right, and again, the thing is that because Rhino is on the ETC, life was always kind of weird to play because you revive things, but you cannot play the Tundra with the life,
Right.
and neither gets discounted.
Right. You almost need to have like the Rhino dead, which you're usually only playing it if you have lethal. So like you're
Right.
setting up to like maybe gamble and get it back, but you probably won't. Yeah, I could see that. I could see that.
And another thing to mention, and that is like, again, which always happened when I was optimizing the list over and over again, is that all the tutoring that we have is specific tutoring. It doesn't say just draw something. And the only thing that says kind of draw anything is tracking.
Yeah.
And because I run two timeline accelerators, if they hit each other, it's fine. But tracking, discovering life, is kind of useless,
Yeah.
especially in the early game.
Yeah. It's like you wasted your tracking. You have to spend another mana to get rid of it. All right, my last question for you, and then we're gonna play some games with it. Have you been thinking about how much dust you are making people spend to craft this deck? Like I see so many people
Yes.
in my chat being like, well, I mean, I would play it, but I don't have Princess. Well, I mean, I would play it, but I don't have the meat wagons. And you know, people are going like the extra mile to craft the True Aim Crescents. They're crafting the mystery eggs they dusted week one because they're like, well, these suck. They're crafting Princess Huhuran. Have you thought about like the amount like the sheer war crime of the dust that you are causing the community to spend?
Yes, and one card you didn't mention is Feign Death, which is also another
Right,
epic.
right. A bunch of people probably don't have Feign
And nine
Death.
lives, yes. And the original list runs only 1/9 lives. Yes, I think it came out around 8K,
Oh my
around 6K dust, 8K dust. I'm sorry.
Oh, wait, was
The
Feign
original
Death for
deck
you, or do we have to
already
cl
had
craft for me
Ukuran, already
too?
had
Now that you
Feign
come
Death,
back.
so you know.
Yeah, I think
Not my fault.
the only free thing, at least Barak is free for now, right? Barak's in core.
Right. Yeah.
All right. Oh man. All
Sorry.
right, let's play a few games. Hopefully we win a few. 'Cause I'd like for this to be one continuous shot.
Oh, it will.
Do
It
most
will.
people own Finley? Yeah, most people own Finley, I would think, at this point.
Yeah, wasn't Finley given for on the
I couldn't
track?
remember if it was free. I couldn't remember if it was
Yeah,
free.
it was given on the
Yeah.
it was given on the track.
Okay. But it was on the paid section.
The diamond one, yes.
The
The other
diamond one.
one, I believe,
The
not.
normal one wasn't? Oh.
No. So you could dust. So you could dust it. So there's people that could actually have dusted us.
I
Thank you.
don't remember. I don't remember that. But that section was so goofy because like they like that section of history was so goofy because they were trying to figure out like, all right, well, how do we compensate people who end up getting the diamond card on like level two, but they packed it and like they didn't quite know what to do about
Sylvanas
it.
versus
Yeah,
Lady
I don't remember exactly.
Dresto.
So Fleur is saying
All
that
shall
he had to craft it.
bless.
So what was the free
Victory for the
legendary from
Forsaken.
Voyage then?
I was it Savara? I think it was Savara. But
No, that was just another diamond.
okay, so
So
it's
if we.
mage. What do I do? Panic?
You still full toss, yeah, no.
Full toss? Okay. What am I looking for? I'm looking for egg and I'm looking for meat wagon.
At this point, yeah, you don't actually really. So the list is so consistent and packed,
I
you don't
see
really
you
care
are
anymore
curious.
about having, I don't know, ETC for Flare.
I'll rip the studies now, or should I wait?
You don't float mana.
Okay.
What?
Talon is
No
sort of
time for
desperate.
games.
Talon can draw the egg,
I can also
but he
draw
can also
bad
draw
stuff.
Huron.
I think I'll just take Talon. I don't think we're ever playing this, but just in case. It's the least useless.
It's
Oh
not
shit.
terrible.
Sorcerer's Gambit.
So we know next turn we're going to play the tracker. Would you rather hero power or play the weapon? I think I'd rather play the weapon in case they somehow play minion. I can play the tracker.
I would normally say play the
And
weapon. I'm probably going to play the weapon.
Yeah, please. No, I was explaining the thought.
Yeah. I think it's Sorcerer. Here's my read, though. It's Sorcerer's Gambit, and we just got a bunch of, like, spell-only cards. I wonder if they're spell, if they're, like, minionless Sorcerer's Gambit mage is the one thing that I was like, very situational to this situation where maybe I want the hero power more, but I don't really think
it
matters.
No, it doesn't. Yeah. And the thing is that in the case they have minions or they somehow managed to get a minion, we now have the weapon and we are able to trade when... If we hadn't, we wouldn't.
Yeah, I'm actually
clearly saying the free legendary is failing.
Phelan, yes.
I believe that, yeah, it is failing.
Yes,
yeah.
Phelan.
Yeah. And Okani was the other one.
Phelan and Okani. There you go.
There we go. Yeah. Exactly. So Flair makes the point that I say. They could have the 4 mana summon, 2-3 drops. So, yeah.
Would you retracker or would you go trinket? Or Varrak?
Good question. No, it's I don't think it's ever Varrak. I think either one is okay. I think I would tracker because I know that we are against a quote-unquote slow deck.
Yeah.
I'm not in a rush to do the thing.
Got you. So you would take the risk and take the one drop to cycle for one sooner if you felt like we were in greater danger.
Right. Yeah. Because, if, for example, it was a real combo deck, I would go for tracker to see if
a real combo deck.
Studies.
Yikes.
Right. Hey, I'm being honest. sorry.
I broke your concentration, I'm sorry.
Yeah, sorry. I would go for Carrion Studies to see if I can get, I don't know, Albatross. I can get something.
Okay, so that looks like that was a... It's a frost spell, so that looks like it's probably Ice Block.
Actually... Egg.
Oh, well, cool. I just high rolled. Sorry.
No, that's fair or square. Again, here, because it's super slow... You could justify playing the Talon because you don't really care if you draw the Huhuren.
Oh, okay.
What we are mostly looking for here is probably being able to time out a good rat if possible. And if you draw the egg, you draw the egg.
I think they forgot they didn't play a fire yet, and now they're like checking their spell list. They're like, wait, why didn't I complete?
Whoopsie-daisy.
Whoopsie-daisy, indeed. So you're not jamming the egg here?
Oh, I am 100% jamming the egg. Okay. Because if it dies, it gives me something that will trigger my 1-1 egg. So
yeah.
I don't care if they transform it. When you play it from hand, it's way more safer than if you cheated with wagon, because you know that you're going to get a 1-1. Only so much time. And you're going to probably get something... to help you follow up the 1-1.
Okay, this is fire, so we might actually get a nice little explosive runes here. Which would be neat.
Yes, and now we actually play the top one for mind games.
Oh, got you.
Showing that you top deck it, like, you know.
Okay, Flame Ward, maybe?
Probably. Maybe, I don't know.
All right, we just pass here, right? We're good.
Yeah, you don't need to. You could jam the other egg. It's not really worth it.
Got you. Yeah, see, that's what I was thinking. It's probably I really want a doggy biscuit, actually. If I can get a doggy biscuit, that's kind of nuts.
Play the sound, though.
Oh, it didn't make the discount? Well, maybe they're running out of location.
It did the discount because now they play a Sirumana Asian Mysteries. But it usually makes a sound, which it didn't this time.
We've got options.
Stop. This is kind of not... We are not in a pickle. And I think we actually play DC for Flair. Victory
is in my Should I do that this turn, though? Or are we waiting?
Yeah, no. You do this turn. And whoops order. Order lord. And we're going to bite or egg. Which, whoops, sets the ETC to 3 HP.
Oopsies.
Yeah.
That's all right.
I said it in the wrong order too.
I won't swing in case it is ice barrier. I have a feeling it's like, I feel like it's like Reno spell sorcerer's gambit. We have not seen a duplicate yet, and
if it was Reno, the only Reno card they could run would be 9-mana Reno, which sounds.
It sounds really bad, doesn't it? But you know where I play. Oh wait, we can get our ETC back.
We most definitely can. I don't think we care that much.
We totally do, right? No, for the Rhino, maybe. Should I go for a mini?
Let's see. So if you play the mini egg and then you play the Devouring Sunworn, I think we do, yeah.
Yeah.
So you do egg, and then you do Huhuran.
Huhuran or Lion, you think?
No, you don't want to pay mana.
Okay.
So, because here what we want to do is try and get the rusher.
So do this now or no?
Yeah. Actually, wait, how many, that's 5 attack. Yeah, you do it now.
Okay.
Now are we playing the egg again?
Yep.
I think we are.
And then I'm just gonna make a board.
Yeah, yes, and you get ETC for Rhino because you have the mana. And actually, I try to save always a 0 mana thing.
Should I flare now?
No.
Okay.
Because we know that they have the other 0 mana secret in hand.
Okay.
I would actually swing up to test for Ice Barrier. So that if they draw the other one, they play it, you know, and they.
Okay.
You want them cycling, so they don't think coming when you play the flare. And the reason I always save a 0 mana thing is that if they deal with this board, silencing anything and you don't get anything back, you cannot really combo now.
Right.
Because you have 8 mana and the cheapest combo you can do is egg and lion from hand, which is 9.
Right. I'm assuming we're going to get flame warded. So if I'm making that move, okay, you play no other secrets. Do we want a flame ward so that we get free shit?
No, because I think we may have lethal because flare into bite our own thing and then rhino. You cannot hide. Maybe lethal.
Okay. So we're gonna swing.
Yeah, you can swing.
Grievous Bite.
Grievous Bite. The lion next to the egg. We get two things. And now we play the rhino. And we get six. And here's the reason for swinging. You create the weapon and did nothing, did you?
Yeah, the weapon did nothing. I would have given them a little bit extra help. Though, look at this. We do get an honorable. Look at that. Look at that. Sweet. Sweet. I'm so happy that if for no other reason, we at least get one win on the video.
You just lost 4 ranks?
What?
You just lost 4 ranks.
Of course I lost 4 ranks. People came in ahead of me. We'll do one more.
You just won.
I know.